Hi guys, in today's video we are going to learn about one tail test, two tail test and the question based on these things. Yeah, and in my previous video which we uploaded recently, I have discussed about the significance level which we are going to use today. So significance level, it specifies the size of the rejection region. Okay, so it is nothing but it is showing rejection region. Okay, and we call this region as a critical region and rejection region. Critical value, the critical value is the first value of the first value to fall inside the critical region. So if our critical region is like this, 1 minute. So if our critical region is suppose here, okay, so this is our critical region. So this first value is called the critical value, CV, critical value. Okay, so without wasting time, let's go straight to the questions, and we are going to do one tail test, two tail test. Yeah, so let's have a question now. So our first question is, here it is. So we will use this table. So here it is. A random variable has distribution, it's binomially distributed, 20 and p, p is the probability. A single observation is used to test. Null hypothesis is given, p is equal to 0.4, and alternative hypothesis, p is not equal to 0.4. So you know, if p is not equal to 0.4, so then we are going for two tail test, right? So here we are going for two tail test. This is clear. Yeah. Now using the 5% significance level. So this is alpha. So alpha is given 5% significance level, and p is given not equal to 0.4. So it means it is two tail test. This is the information we can extract from here. Okay, now using 5% level of significance, find the critical region, that is rejection region you need to find, and the B part, actual significance level of the test. Yeah, so let's start our question. Okay, so first thing what we do, it is two tail test, so alpha will be divided, so 5 divided by 2, that is 2.5. so 2.5% like 0.025. so 0.025 will be here. Okay, so this will be 0.025. okay, and this will be here. So alpha is divided in two tail test, so alpha divided by 2, so 0.025, and this is also 0.025. yeah, this is the first thing we have done. Now this is called lower end and this is called top end. So we are going to solve this question first, lower end. So let's write down here, looking at lower end. So looking at lower end, right? So we are dealing in this area. So because our significance level for this area is 0.025, yeah, so we need to see from the binomial distribution table where is the overlapping of 0.025. I repeat, where is the overlapping of 0.025. so if we see the table, I can show you here table. Okay, if you see here, we have given n is 20, so that is 20, and probability is given 0.4, so we are going for this. So n is 20, probability is 0.4. now overlap of 0.025, so if we see overlap of 0.025, it is 0.0160. so this is the first value we are getting. Yeah, 0.0160, if we are going for decimal place. Yeah, so this value is in front of 3, so we can write down here probability x less than and equal to 3. Why we are putting less than and equal to sign? Because this table is only available for less than and equal to. So less than and equal to 3, and this is given 0.0160. So 0.0160, and which is less than our significance level, that is 0.025. Okay, now then we'll because overlap of 0.025 is between this value and this value, so next value we are taking 0.0510, so that is for 4. So again we can write down p x less than and equal to 4, and this value is 0.0510. I'm taking decimals 4 places, and this value is greater than 0.025. Yeah, so now in this case, so our critical value will be 3, so means this value will be 3 here. Critical value will be 3, so this is our critical value, which is equal to 3. So we can write down here critical value is 3. So we are going for this because this is less than 0.025. Less than 0.025 will be this area, and the first value of this region will be 3. So that is our critical value. Yeah, I hope things are clear. Now what will be the critical region? So this shaded part is called critical region. Okay, so our critical region I can denote by CR. CR stands for critical region. It should be between 0, 1, 2 and 3. 3 is included. So this is for the lower end. So same thing we can do for the top end. Okay, so we have seen that looking at lower end, this is looking at lower end, and we have found our critical value is 3 and critical region is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Now we are going for this region, that is for the top end. So let's now we are going to see this region. What about this? So this is looking at the top end. So I'm going to write down, I'll change ink now and write down looking at top end. Okay, looking at top end. Now here you need to understand just one thing that is really important. If you see here, okay, this whole probability is 1. Yeah, so from 1, if you take away this, because this whole probability is 1 from here till here, it is 1. So from 1, if you take away this, then you are left with this area. Okay, then you are left with this area. So this is what we are going to do first. So from 1, sorry about that. So from 1, it is we are going to take away 1 minus 0.025, and which is equal to 0.975. okay, now we will see overlap of 0.975 in front of 20 and under 0.4. so under 0.4 in this line and n is 20. So overlap of 0.975, if you see, so this is 979, this is 979, so this is first value, and so 975, and next value will be this. So we are taking these two value because 975 is dancing between these two value, so it is overlapping. So we are taking 12 and 13. So we'll write down separately here. For x equal to 12, we are getting 0.9790, and for x equal to 13, we are getting value 0.994. Okay, so it will be 0. 994. Yeah, okay, so this is what we have got it. Now very important thing, so important thing what you need to do, this table is available only for less than and equal to value, and here because we are going this side, so this value is greater side, this value is greater than. Yeah, so how we can convert greater than into, so this we have studied in the previous topic, statistical distribution. So we want until 12, so you can add one here like p x greater than equal to 13. We want value until 12. Yeah, so x greater than equal to 13, you can write down 1 minus p x less than and equal to 12. Okay, similarly for this 13 value, you can add one here, you can write down p x greater than or equal to 14, because we are looking for the top end, so for top end we are putting this sign, and this table is available only for less than value, so we are changing into less than, x less than and equal to 13. Okay, so this is what we have got. Now so 1 minus x less than and equal to 2 value is 0.9790, so 0.9790, so 1 take away 0.970, it will be 0.021, and from 1 take away 13 value is 0.9940, this will be equal to, so it will be 0.006. yeah, 0.006. this is what we have got so far. Yeah, so important thing was, because we want value until 12, so until 12, so you can add one here, and we are going for 13, so x greater than 13, you can write down x minus 12. So this is really important step, because we want total 13 value. So how we can get 13 value? So x greater than 14, 1 minus p x less than equal to 13. So this is what we have got so far. Yeah, so if you see here, because x greater than equal to 13, so this area, so this will be greater than equal to 13, so here first value we will get 13, so this will be our critical value. Okay, and this is our critical region, so let's write down here. So our critical value CV, that is 13. Okay, and our critical region, that is CR, is given by value greater than 13. Value greater than 13 is because our total fixed values are 20. If you see here, our total fixed values are 20. Here, total fixed values are 20. So 13 to 20 we need to write down. So let's write down here 13 to 20. So bracket. So 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19 and 20 and bracket close. Is that okay? So this is our critical region. Now in the question, they are asking, what is, if you see B part, critical region we have found. Now write down the actual significance level. So actual significance level, how we will do it? So let's write down here actual significance level. Actual significance, very easy, level. Yeah, so actual significance level we will take, because our critical region is x greater than equal to 13 on the right hand side, so we are taking this value. Okay, and here critical region is less than and equal to 3, so we are taking this 0.0160, this value, so we can add these two values. Okay, so let's add these two value, so actual significance level will be 0.0160 plus 0.021. if you add them, then it will be 0.0370. Okay, or you can say 3.7%, right? This is our actual significance level. So here we complete our first question. I took time to explain this question, but I hope concepts are clear. Let's move towards the next question. So our next question is, a random variable has a distribution binomially 20 and p. A single observation is used to where null hypothesis is given by p is equal to 0.15, and against alternative hypothesis given p less than 0.15. So see here is p less than 0.15. So let's write down. So it means it is indicating our one tail test, and because it is on the left hand side, so we are talking about the lower end. So let's write down all the details here. X is distributed binomially 20 and p, and null hypothesis is given p is 0.15, and alternative hypothesis given p is less than and equal to less than 0.15. yeah, and remember, alternative hypothesis does not carry equal sign, only null hypothesis carry equal sign. So please remember this. So p is less than 0.15. okay, so because it is less than, so it is one tail test, and we are talking about the lower end. Yeah, so this is called lower end. So this, we are talking about this end, lower end, right? Now what is significance level? So alpha is 5%. 5% means it is 0.05. okay, so it means this region is 0.05. yeah, so we are talking about this region. So this is given 0.05. okay, now we are looking at lower end. So looking at lower end, okay, looking at lower end, so we will see. So here we are not dividing alpha for one tail test. We don't divide alpha by 2. So we are looking for overlap of 0.05. so for 20 under 0.15, so this is 20 under 0.15, overlap of 0.05. so if you see overlap of 0.05, here it is 0.0388, and the next value is 0.1756. so these two values are overlap. So we can write down here p x less than and equal to 0 is given by 0.388 and one more 8, yeah, 3 8s, and p x less than and equal to 1 is given by 0.1756. okay, so this value is less than 0.05, this value is greater than 0.05. okay, so less than 0.05, so our critical reason will be 0, because less than 0. So our critical reason will be 0, okay, because less than and equal to 0. So this reason will be less than and equal to 0. So critical reason is 0. We are getting only one value. I hope this is clear. Yeah, now let's go for another question. So here a test statistics has a distribution, so is given 10 and p, and null hypothesis given p is 0.2, alternative hypothesis given is 0.2. so see here it is greater than 0.2. so we are talking about one tail test, and it will be towards the top end here, not the lower end. So top end, and find the critical reason for the test using a 5% significant level. So x is distributed binomially, it is 10 and p, and null hypothesis H0 is given, p is 0.2. null hypothesis always have equal sign, alternative hypothesis always have less than and equal, less than and greater than sign, so greater than 0.2. so we are talking about the top end here. Okay, now so we are looking at top end, looking at top end. Yes, so top end. So alpha is 0.05, so this region will be 0.05. No need to divide by 2 because this is not two tail test. Okay, now as I told you, this whole probability is 1. From here till here it is 1, and we are talking about this area. So this area from 1 we can take away 0.05, it will be 0.95, and we will see overlap of 0.95 in front for n equal to 10, and under probability is 0.2. So here it is 0.2, and in front of 10 we will see overlap of 0.95. So we need to scroll this. So let's scroll this. Okay, so 1 minute, little bit. So overlap of 0.95. So if we see overlap of 0.95 is under 0.2. Okay, under 0.2, so it is coming for okay, it is 0.2, so definitely this is not 0.2, this is 0.2, and it is coming overlap of 0.8791. this value is for 3, and the next value is 9672, this one, yeah, so 4. So we can write down here for x equal to 3, it is, I'm just writing roughly 0.8791, and for x equal to 4 we are getting this value 0.9672. Okay, I hope things are clear now. Now because we need to add one here, why add one here? Because we want this table is for less than value and we are going for greater than value. So what we need to do, sorry about that, yeah, what we need to do, we want value greater than 4. Greater than 4, then we can use this 3 and we can write down 1 minus probability x less than and equal to 3. Okay, and similarly here we add 1 here, so it will be p x greater than equal to 5, it will be 1 minus p x less than and equal to 4. Yeah, so we are using 3 and 4 value. How we can use 3 and 4 value? Because we need to go towards the top end. Top end is greater than, so greater than you can convert it into less than by using this result. This we have studied in statistical distribution in the previous topic. Now let's write down here, 1 minus x less than and equal to 3 is 0.8791, which we got 0.1209, which is greater than 0.05. okay, now here 1 minus less than 4 is 0.9672. If you minus it, you get 0.0328, which is less than 0.05. okay, so because we are looking for top end, so value greater than 0.05 we are considering, so we are going to consider this value. Okay, so our critical value will be, okay, our critical value will be 5, yeah, okay, and critical region, so we are taking we are going for this value x greater than 5, yeah, so our critical value will be 5, okay, and critical region will be x greater than and equal to 5. So greater than equal to 5 means you are going for 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, so I hope things are clear here. So because we are looking for top end, top end. So this value will be our 5, and this right hand side value will be greater than 5, like 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, like that. Yeah, okay. I hope concept is clear. In case if concept is not clear, so you can watch this video again and things will be fine. Yeah, so I hope you have liked the videos. Please give me your comments if you like the video, and it will encourage us to make more videos. Thank you. Thanks for watching.